Hey everybody, my name is Lisa Miller. I'm the Director of Counseling here at StartBupe. Welcome to our bi-weekly video. My goodness, feeling all the love here. So, I'm recording this on Valentine's Day, and you're probably seeing it a few days later, but I definitely wanted to share some things with you about the day that came to me this morning. So, this morning I was walking my dog, and I realized what day it was, and I'm like, wow, it's love day. And then I was like, what is love?
What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me no more.
Okay, yes, and that song came to me. I love it. But really, what is love? So I think if you took 10 people, you could probably have 10 different answers of what people would think how to describe love. But so I wanted to turn it around and talk about self-love in recovery, which is something really important for everybody to learn how to do. Because for a long time when you were using, you probably weren't taking care of yourself physically as well as you should, and definitely emotionally or mentally. So now you have to learn something new that's going to help you speed up your process in recovery, right? So this is another tool. Here you go. That you can use to help you reach your goal sooner than you thought you could. We're gonna talk about 5 tips to help you learn and practice self-care that are important in recovery. All right, number one. First one is mindfulness. Mindfulness, it seems like such a mysterious word, right? What is mindfulness? Mindfulness is just like it sounds. When you're feeling physical things or emotional things, it's just kind of staying in that moment, right? So a lot of times when we start feeling these uncomfortable emotions, we want to run because that's what we've been doing the whole time when we were in active use. It's like these feelings are scary and they don't feel good and it doesn't feel normal. But that's what you have to do to learn who you are as a person. So you stay in these feelings when you're feeling them and they're uncomfortable. And then you get a glimpse of who you are in here and in here, and you can adjust accordingly, right? So getting to know yourself again after being in active use is really important, okay? Number 2 is connect with like-minded people. What does that mean? So it means just what it says. So basically, get to some groups. If you don't like 12-step because you don't like or you don't believe in God, that's fine. They have all different kinds of groups that'll help you with recovery. Smart Recovery is one of them. You can go online and look. There's online groups that you can do from sitting on your couch. It's so much easier now than it used to be. So connect with some like-minded people. You're different than you used to be. Now you need some different people, which is another one of the tips down coming up. Number 3, find some balance in your life. It's real easy in early recovery to say, I'm going to do this every day because that's going to keep me focused, and I'm not going to use because I'm going to be doing this. All right. And so what happens is a lot of times people get carried away. They focus only on that activity. And guess what happens? They burn out from that activity. Then they don't do it at all. And then what happens? Exactly. So you want to find a really healthy balance between your work, your recovery, your family, your schooling, whatever it is that you have going on in your life, balance is the key, okay? Number 4 is take time to get to know you, like we were talking about before. You haven't known yourself. You've been running away from yourself. So put yourself out there. Find out not only what you like, but find out things you like to do. So you might have to go to a park, see if you enjoy being outdoors, go for a hike. Go to a botanical gardens, like play some games with your kids, all kinds of things. You have to reinvent who you are because for a long time, what you liked doing was using. And we're not doing that anymore because that wasn't a healthy outcome. So figure out who you are, spend some time. You're not going to feel comfortable going bowling, right? Because you haven't been bowling in 20 years, but go do it. You might enjoy it. Pick up a book. Maybe that'll help you, right? Do all kinds of things that are going to feel uncomfortable. But then when you do them a few times, you might say, oh, I really like bowling. That really made me feel good and kept me sober tonight. Or, wow, this book has really spoken to me spiritually. Whatever the case is, keep trying new things and find out who you are, really. Okay. last but not least, this is a hard one for everybody, including myself. Setting boundaries. So setting boundaries is more so when you're been using and you're not anymore. You can't hang out with the same people, places, and things that you used to because it's not going to be safe. And most likely those friends aren't going to respect where you're at. They might say, yeah, good for you, but guess what? They still might come over and have something on them. And that's just going to be a temptation that you can't afford to go there, right? Or that you can't handle. Eventually, if it's right there, it's like an alcoholic going to a bar. Eventually, you're going to have a drink. So set your boundaries. It's okay to make new friends. It is going to feel a little uncomfortable, but what we talked about before is being uncomfortable is what? Growth, getting to know yourself, much needed. All right, if you guys have any questions, please call me. Take it easy on yourself, and peace from StartBupe.